Today, the topic of our video is that we will discuss the concept of congruent or congruency. Then we will discuss the concept of congruency of triangles. Then we will prove the theorems of congruent triangles in which there are congruency between angle, side and angle, and side, angle, angle. Concept of congruent. Word congruent means identical, similar to, or in correspondence. Congruency is the property of geometrical figures. Two figures are congruent if they have exactly the same shape and size. This symbol means congruent two. Now the concept of congruent triangles. Let triangle ABC and DEF, these are the two figures of two triangles in which the name of the vertices are here is A, here is B, here is C, and here is D, E, and F. Now they are congruent if and only if the sides and angles are congruent. If AB side is congruent to DE side and BC side is congruent to EF side, or CA is congruent to FD. This is the first condition of congruency, that if sides of the triangles, two triangles, are congruent, then we can say that the triangles are congruent. Now, if angle A is congruent to angle D, angle B is congruent to angle E, and angle C is also congruent to angle F, then we can say that triangle ABC is congruent to angle DEF, and this is denoted by this sign. Congruent means that both the triangles are similar, or they are in correspondence, or they are identical, and in geometry or in mathematics we have the conditions that if the sides and angles are congruent, then the triangles are also congruent. Hope you have understood this concept of congruent triangles. Now we have the theorem of congruency of triangles, that the statement is, in any correspondence of two triangles, if one side and any two angles of one triangle are congruent to the corresponding side and angles of the other, then the triangles are congruent. Now this is the statement of the theorem and we have to prove it. Now you can see that what is given, that in correspondence there are two triangles, triangle A, let's say they are ABC and triangle DEF. Here we have drawn triangle ABC and triangle DEF, and they are in correspondence, which means that it is given that one side, let's say side BC, is congruent to side EF, that this side BC is congruent to side EF of the other triangle. And one more thing that is given is that any two of the angles of the triangle are also congruent to the corresponding angles. Now we will say that angle A is congruent to angle D and angle B is congruent to angle E. Now what we have to prove is that the triangles are also congruent, that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. Now from the statement you can see that one side and two angles, this means that angle, side, angle. Now how we will prove it? In correspondence, triangle ABC corresponds with triangle DEF, and angle B is congruent to angle E. This is given. Similarly, side BC is congruent to side EF. This is also given. So we can say that angle C is also congruent to angle F, because if angle A is congruent to angle D, angle B is congruent to angle E, so angle C should also be congruent to angle F, because this was given to us. Now you can see that if one angle is congruent, then the side is also congruent, then angle is also congruent. So we can conclude that the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF by using angle side angle postulate. Angle side angle of one triangle is congruent to angle side angle of the other other triangle. In this way, we have proved this theorem that if one side and two angles of one triangle is congruent to one side and two angles of the other triangle, both the triangles are also congruent to each other. Hope you have understood this concept of the theorem. Now, the theorem number 2 states that if two angles of a triangle are congruent, then the sides opposite to them are also congruent. Now, in the statement, you can see one triangle is given to us, and it is saying that two angles of a triangle are congruent, then the sides opposite to them are also congruent. Now, given is that there is a triangle, triangle ABC. There is a triangle ABC, in which angle B is congruent to angle C. This is given to us. Now, what we have to prove is that the side opposite to the angle, the side opposite to angle B is side AC. This is congruent to the side opposite to angle C, that is AB. This means AB is congruent to AC. This we have to prove. Now, as we know the property of congruency of triangles, so what we will do, we will do some construction work. What we will do, we will draw a bisector here of angle A that cuts side BC at point D, and we say that we have constructed a triangle in such a way that now you can see the figure is divided into two triangles. One triangle is ADB, the other is ACD. Now there are two triangles in the figure. First, in the statement, we were given that there is one triangle in which two angles are congruent, and we have to prove that sides opposite to the triangles should also be congruent. That we have to prove. Now, how we can do it in a single triangle? We have no other options, but we can use the property of the congruency of the triangle. So what we have done is we have made an angle bisector by dividing this one triangle into two triangles. Now there are two triangles, triangle ABD and triangle ACD. Hope you have understood this part of the theorem. Now we will prove it. Statement: in correspondence to triangle ABD and triangle ACD, you can see that this AD is the common side of both the triangles. This means AD is congruent to AD in both the triangles. This is the reason is because this is common. Now angle B is congruent to angle C. This is given to us. Now angle BAD is congruent to angle CAD. This is done by the construction. Now triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD, side angle angle postulate, that one side and two angles are congruent in one triangle. One side and two angles of one triangle is congruent with one side and two angles. This is side angle angle is congruent to side angle angle of both the triangles. So in this way, the side AB is congruent to side AC. This is the corresponding sides of the congruent triangles. because we have now two triangles. One triangle is ABD, the other triangle is ACD. AD is congruent to AD, side AD is congruent to side AD, this is common. Angle B is congruent to angle C. Angle A is congruent to angle A. So side AB is also congruent to side AC. In this way we have proved this theorem. Hope you have understood the whole concept of congruency. What is the meaning of congruency? How we use it in the theorems to prove the concept of congruency in the triangle. Then side angle angle and angle side angle postulate, and you will practice. Thank you.